إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Al-Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Al-Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Al-Islam. After this, I greet you all with the greeting of Al-Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our tafsir, or weekly classes tafsir. And this is the fourth class, if I'm not mistaken, for Surah Al-Kahf, Surah number 18. And we finish so far one verse, Alhamdulillah. And today, inshallah, we're going to be talking about the second verse in Surah Al-Kahf. Again, Surah Al-Kahf, Surah number 18. And the name of it in Arabic, Al-Kahf. In English, translated as the cave. And a kahf is a place or a room or a hole in a top of a mountain, which usually used for refuge, shelter, hiding. It can be small, it can be big, but this what is a cave is. Surah Al-Kahf, Surah number 18, the cave. The second verse reads as قَيِّمًا لِيُنذِرَ بَأْسًا شَدِيدًا مِنْ لَدُنْ وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصالحات الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا. Again, قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدن ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا. قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدن ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا. General translation for this verse. He has made it straight to give warning to the disbelievers of a severe punishment from him and to give glad tidings to the believers in the oneness of Allah, Islamic monotheism, who do righteous deeds, that they shall have a fair reward, i.e. paradise. This is a translation of the verse according Muhsin Khan in the Noble Quran. Now we're going to go after this with the verse number 2, word by word. And after this, inshallah, we're going to go with a general translation or meaning, which we may call it tafsir, inshallah. Qayyiman, straight لِيُنذِرَ, to give warning, بَأْسًا, punishment, شَدِيدًا, severe, مِنْ, from, لَدُنْ, him, ويبشر, and to give glad tidings, المؤمنين, the believers, الذين, who يعملون, work, الصالحات, righteous deed, أن, that, لهم, they shall have أجرا reward حسنا good now break down more the words قيما straight لينذر this is a verb and prefix with lam what you call lam تعليل or to show you the purpose for what like you say I go to school لأتعلم I go to school to learn so we use the lam I go to the mosque لأصلي لأدرس التفسير so this is lam giving you a reason why this is lam by itself he say I do such and such for or because lam and after this comes a verb ينذر there is انذار there is a نذير there is منذر okay All this derived from the word نذر or أنذر نذر أنذر ينذر نذير نذير is a warner أنذر he had warned لينذر in the past tense so for purpose of giving warning to warn لينذر Why did the Quran came down? لِيُنذِرَ To warn. To give warning. بَأْسًا بَأْس mean punishment. Hardship, difficulty. بَأْس شديد من hard severe so شديد is describing the بأس so you have a noun and you have a صفة you have بأس which is hardship or punishment qualified by the next word بأسا شديدا is severe Punishment. من لدن is two separate things. Men from. لدن and the ها which is a pronoun that from his or from him. The punishment is from him referring to Allah. Ladun is a possession. You say ladayya wa ladayya. That means I have. Ladun. Okay. A term of possession. Mil ladun who? Ladun. This is the originality and you said لدنها لدني لدنكم okay من لدنه from him ويبشر from بشارة بشر يبشر and the person who gives the glad tidings we call him what بشير okay مبشر he's a بشير or he's a مبشر You say Abshir, okay? Good news to you. You say Abshir, okay? And Bashar. Why you Bashir? So also the Quran to give a glad tidings. To whom? He said, Al-Mu'mineen. Al-Mu'mineen. Al-Mu'mineen is the plural of Mu'min. A believer. The believers, Al-Mu'mineen. Usually the word is say Al-Mu'minun. Okay? But the grammar here affects the word because this here in possession, what you call maf'ul be, when the act fall in somebody now became with nasb, with fatha, or became with zaya if it's plural. So he did not say al-mu'minun. That will be mu'minun when he start the sentence with. But now the word in the middle of the sentence. So it been effect. So now instead of mu'minun, al-mu'minin is still the same, the believers. Al-ladhina, those, and now qualifying them by saying what? Ya'maluna, from amal. And the believers, plural, so now the ya'maluna became what? Also jam' mu'minun, ya'malun, okay? يعملون those who do work. يعملون الصالحات. الصالحات is a plural. صالح. صالحة. صالحات. الصالحات good deed. Righteous deed. أن that. لهم is two things together. The lam and the hum. Lam, here two or four. Whom they, that mean for them. Ajran, from ajr. Ajran, ajrun, ajran, ajrin is still the same. It depends where is the word fall in the sentence. Okay? Vowels, okay? Nunation, fatha, kasra, dhamma, it depends where is the word in the sentence. But still the word is ajr, reward. What you pay the taxi, the cab driver, you give him ajr. The person who work, you give him ajr. When you do work, Allah reward you. He pay you. Okay? He compensate you. What kind of ajr? Qualified it again with sifa. Description, say hasana, good reward. Not only any reward, but a godly reward. Yes.
What is the opposite of ajr? Is ajr always the good reward? Is the hasana implied in the word ajr?
Hasana is the opposite of it, will be sayyi'ah. Okay? The opposite of hasana is sayyi'a. Reward, it can be utilized for both. So because it is a reward or compensation, it's going to be according what you did. As a result of this, came here to see ajran hasana. Because I can pay you, but I'm paying you as a result of what you did. You did good or bad. Okay? Like a rent, you're paying rent, okay? Ajr, hasana.
Can we talk about the first word, qayyiman?
I only break in the words as words. But now with the tafsir, you get to know more what it is, qayyiman. Okay?
Okay? I didn't understand what it means in the context of this.
Okay, it referring to the previous verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying what? Alhamdulillahi alladhi anzala ala abidihi al-kitaba wa lam yaj'al lahu iwaja. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has sent the book on his slave servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and doesn't allow any crookedness in it. Qayyiman. So now he's going to talk more about the Quran. So he said he gave him the book. And the book has no crookedness in it. And now he's saying more about the book in the second verse saying, قَيِّمًا. that means straight or iqayim in charge. You see? So now it is still talking about this book that Allah had given to the Prophet Muhammad. The thing that we praise Allah for, because the guidance of Allah had came down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show his mercy towards us by sending us a guidance, sending a book. What is the qualification or what is the quality of this book? Qayyiman also. Number one was what? That is kitab. To be written, to be collected. Okay? أنزل الكتاب على عبده. Number first, number one, that was منزل, is not made, is revealed, came from high authority. Number two, he make it a kitab, to be recorded, not to be forgotten, to be compiled, not to get lost. Okay? Yes, all these things. And after this, لم يجعل له عوجة. He didn't allow any crookedness in it. And after this, come to qualify the book again to say Qayyiman. And we're going to talk about it, this our subject now, inshallah, about Qayyiman. And let's stop here for a moment and go to see what Sheikh Muhammad Mutawalli al-Sha'rawi, rahmatullahi alayhi, is saying about Qayyiman. Qayyiman is referring to the Quran. It been said Qayyim, that means straight. Okay? And this is one from the meaning of the word Qayyim. And Qayyim is qualifying the Quran, describing the Quran. Okay? The word Qayyim coming to describe the book that been revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that is Qayyim. And he's saying that this word, as if it came to firm and confirm what came before, وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ عِوَجَ. So that means Allah given another word to emphasize what he said about the Quran before, that has no crookedness. So he said, لَمْ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ عِوَجًا, because the opposite of عِوَج, crookedness, is istiqama, straightforward. So as if he's saying, for sure, no crookedness, it is straight. Okay? This is one. Because istiqama, straightforward, and crookedness, iwaj, maybe you could not see it with your naked eye. It needs some kind of balance and a scale so sensitive, so you can discover how crooked or straight. This reality, you will see it on the road, which is been having curves. The first time you look to it, you see and you believe and you think that it's straight, like where you are in the highway. Okay, you have a sidewalk or you have a curve. And when you look, it seems that it's straight. Okay? But when the rain comes down, it will expose this reality and will show you what defect in that road. So now you can see, because if the road, if it's straight and flat and even, what's going to happen to the rain? It's going to stay still on the ground. But when you see it's running to the side, okay, now you got to know that there is some kind of crookedness or tilting Okay? But you could not see it with your own eyes when you look to it. You see? So here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enforce the first meaning by saying qayyiman. Because before he said, he didn't allow any crookedness. But maybe we don't see it, but if you study, you will feel the crookedness. So Allah emphasized it with another word. He said, qayyiman, it is mustaqim. Okay? It is with no doubt. There is no any inch of crookedness in this Quran. There is no any confusion. There is no anything that can bring about misunderstanding. Is your mind, is your vision, is there your own way of seeing things, but is not, because he gave more emphasis and said, number one, he negate, and number two, in the second verse, emphasize it with another quality by saying qayyiman. Also, the meaning of qayyim is muhayyin, muhaymin, the one who's in charge, the one who have authority, okay? You, as example, you say so-and-so is qayyim on so-and-so. That means so-and-so is in charge of so-and-so. So you are in charge, you are supervisor. Okay? You call it qayyim. Also, a person who take care of the affairs of someone else. As a result, the Quran has no crookedness in it, and in the same timing, it have authority over the previous books and the previous revelation. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states this clear in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse number 48. وَأَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ. Indeed, we reveal this book to you, Muhammad, with the truth, confirming what had been revealed before from revelation, and a supervisor, a monitoring, making sure that everything going okay. So, the Quran is mustaqim, straight, or that the Quran is in charge, or that he's both. So that means the Quran will tell you what's in this book is not correct. God has no son. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. So now when the come is saying me and the Father are one, okay, now he comes, the Quran say, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. When the Yahud saying, okay, وقالت اليهود يد الله مغلولة, and the Jews said that the hand of Allah is tied, غلت أيديهم ولعنوا بما كفر بل يداه مبسوطتان, they curse for what they said. Indeed, the two hands of Allah open wide, he spinned. He's given the people, he's given the animals, he's given the birds, he's given everybody. You see? So now the Quran became a monitor, supervisor over the previous revelation to show you what is right and what is wrong. Why? Because all the previous revelation been left بِمَسْتُحْفِذُوا مِنَ الْكِتَابِ. Allah had left it up to the nations, the priests, the monks, the learned people to watch over and to protect it, make sure nothing happened to the Torah, nothing happened to the Injil. But a human being work, it maybe take 10 years, 20 years, 100 years, and after this, you know, human being, the nature, they forget, they neglect, they go someplace else. Now the Tawheed turned to a shirk. The one weren't one turned to three. But as for the Quran, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. Allah say, indeed, I reveal the Quran and is upon me to protect it. So this is a different. Previous books, we let the scholars and the people, this generation, everybody take care of it. Why? Because it's not been meant or intended by Allah to be a revelation forever and law forever. It's something temporary for a nation, for a community. But when Islam came, when Quran came, when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came, Allah had intended to be forever until the day of judgment. So now we need a more knowledge, more mechanism, more power than manpower. And this is Allah. So he said, I reveal it, I take care of it, make sure nothing happened to it. Now, nowadays, 1400 years ago, and now still we have the same Quran. Doesn't matter where is the Quran printed, in India, in Egypt, in Africa, in France, open chapter 5, verse number 48, you will find the same word, how it started and how it ended. How it can be, subhanAllah, is a miracle. How? There is no government, there is no country stand to say, we're going to make sure that this Quran is not going to change. You don't go open Surah Al-Ma'idah, in one Quran, you found it a 50 verse, and in another Quran, you will find it 52. And the other Quran that printed in India is 60. And the one that printed in Africa is 25. You even will find it word by word and vowels. Vowels. Can you imagine this? Even the sound of the Quran. If I say to you, Alhamdulillah, Rabbi, I say, Alhamdu. Even a little kid, 5 years old, he will correct me. 5 years old. Subhanallah. And as the letters is still Alif, Lam, Ha, Mim, Dal. But you break one vowel, somebody jump right away for you. So it's not only the Quran in letters, in vowels, in sound, in meaning. So the Quran became what? A master and supervisor over the previous book. Qayyiman. Okay? Allah is saying what? Al-Rijalu Qawwamuna ala al-Nisa. Men are in charge of women. It's your job to make sure that electric bill is paid. You take care of this. The kids understand this. The wife have clothes. They have food. You are in charge. Okay? Oh, don't do this, you do that. Okay? So the Quran, Qayyiman, on what? And what been revealed before? Because it will be lies, fabrication, addition. And look today, the Bible by the Mormon, by Jehovah's Witness, by King James, Jerusalem Bible, you can count. But can you bring a different Quran? Oh yeah, guys, you have a different Quran. Where? Big Tall, Muhammad Mohsin Khan Noble Quran. What's his name? No. Hold it. What are you talking about? This is a translation of the meaning of the Quran. This is not different Qurans. Allah is saying what? Inna anzalnahu Quranan Arabiyyan la'allakum ta'qilun. This is not Quran. What's Quran is what you read? Alif Lam Mim. This was Quran. Allah said, indeed we had revealed the Arabic Quran. Aramaic. Who is speaking Aramaic today? The original language of the Torah or the Injil is not exist. Show me one country that their tongue or their mother tongue nowadays, they talk Aramaic. You have few words here and there and dictionaries. But the language of the Quran is still living language. They speak it, they write it. Countries, even non-Arab countries, they learn Arabic. You see? Now you see what is Qayyiman? I could not say all this when I told you. But when you go to the tafsir, now you swim down in the ocean and you can get all this. So the Quran is Qayyim, supervisor, protector, in charge of all the previous books. It is straight and it is qayyim, muhaymin. And this Quran came also for what? Qayyiman. Stop. Liyunzira. What is the Quran came now? You remember what I said in the beginning, the lamb? Liyunzira. To warn, for purpose of warning. Okay? Give warning, liyunzira. Min ladun. The one who said in the beginning what? Alhamdulillah. Now it coming with the warning. ثم يقول الله تبارك وتعالى لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدن. يقول الشيخ محمد متولي الشعراوي رحمة الله عليه وهذه هي العلة من الإنزال. And this was the purpose behind sending the Quran down is to warn. So, now you don't have excuse in the day of the judgment. Did I send a prophet? Yes, Allah. Did I send book? Yes, Allah. But the prophet died, but the book didn't die. Yes, the Prophet Muhammad is not here, but because we are not worshiping Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he came only to explain, he did his mission, he's gone. But the message, don't worry about the messenger now. The message is there or not. Did it reach you or not? Can you see the halal and the haram there or not? Yes. So what's your excuse with Allah? So it has to be. And this is the mercy of Allah. That you have no excuse in the day of judgment. The message had reached you. If it didn't reach you, this is something else. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying what? وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. Never. وَمَا كُنَّ مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى. Yeah, it has to be. Never Allah punish a community unless he send what? A messenger, a warner to them. He will come and tell them, وَعَلَيْكُمْ السَّلَامُ وَحْتُ اللَّهِ. So if the messenger didn't come, or the people happen to be in an area that is no TV, there is no internet, there is no satellite, there is nobody to tell them about Quran. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, okay, he didn't get a nadir, he didn't get a warner, he didn't see the book, he didn't know anything. No problem. We are not sending you to hellfire. Come, we give you a test here in the day of judgment. On the spot. Okay? So Allah is fair. Okay? لِيُنذِرَ. So this is fair. So الانذار is a must before the punishment. Now we see the mercy. Okay? He doesn't take one and throw him in hellfire. No. Now, did you come? Did we warn you? Did he tell you? Did we let you know that red light means to stop? And this can cause, you understand, collision and cause. Now you, okay. Now it's your fault. Did Allah give you an ear? Did Allah give you eye? You can understand. So what else? Use it. Al-Inzar, the warning, is to warn people, to alert people with an evil or something serious is going to befall in them. Wal-Munzar huna al-Kuffar, those who are receiving the warning are the disbelievers. That because the severe warning with a punishment is not for anyone except the kuffar. So the Quran did not come to warn the believers. The believers did not need a warning. But the kuffar, the warning for them. Okay? After this, he described the punishment. Not only a warning, he said shadidan. Okay? So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasizes this more, because he doesn't want you to go to hellfire. Okay? Because if he tells you, okay, we'll be on. But he's making it for you to know that it is serious. Because Allah doesn't want you to go to hellfire. Okay? So he emphasizes it more. Okay? So the word yunzir by itself is supposed to put fear in you. But when he comes and bring another word, is to emphasize it more. Alright? Ba'san shadidan. لِيُنذِرَ بَأْسًا شَدِيدًا And it's not this only, it's saying مِنْ لَدُنْ From him. So why came this word لَدُنْ? Pay attention here. Because whatever actions happen, it comes to match the doer of the action. Can you imagine that your child step in your toe? Okay? Now, your wife step in your toe. Now a camel stepped in your toe. Now a car went over your toe. All this you call a step on my toe or run over my toe. But is the pain and the suffering when your child stepped in your toe like a camel, like a car? So do you understand now? So when it comes, the action and the impact of the action according to the doer. So Allah is saying, لِيُنذِرَ بَأْسًا شَدِيدًا And he keep emphasizing more for you to put a fear and stay away from this kufr. And he said, مِنْ لَدُنْ From him. Who's him? Allah. So can you imagine now what kind of punishment going to be? Okay? So if the word, your yunzir, it didn't make it clear enough for you and put fear enough in you. And the word shadidan, severe, it didn't also make it clear enough to you. Now let the word ladunhu is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He Himself. I'm sorry, my brothers and sisters. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Please apologize to all of you. I didn't know that we disconnected, but inshallah, we put it on you for the site. Inshallah, next time I'm going to put somebody beside me to keep eye on the site, so he will lose the beauty of the class, and he will, but no problem. Inshallah, alhamdulillah. من لدن والعذاب يتناسب مع المعذب وقوته. So, if the punishment coming from Allah, من لدن, from Him, so that means there is no way for you to bear this and to take this punishment. And there is no way that you can escape it because it's from Allah. Now you see, min ladun, ladunna, from us, from ladunkum. So this term, ladun, is to possess and you add the pronoun to it and you can use from ladunni or ladunkum or, okay? So min ladun, this put more emphasis and shows you how serious this warning and the punishment is coming from Allah. But after this, he found the Quran always takes the methodology of two. Like a bird fly with what? How many wings? Two wings. Okay? So the Quran always and the hadith always take something called targhib and tarhib. And by the way, there is a book called Targhib and the Tarhib lil Imam al-Munziri, rahmatullah alayh. Okay? So is encouragement give you things to encourage you to do such a thing. And even if you go in Riyad al-Salihin, you found in the index, okay, certain ahadith to encourage you to do things, and other ahadith to do what? They discourage you. So one targhib by telling you about the blessings and the reward and the closeness to Allah and. And one is tarhib tells you how serious it is and how bad it is and being distant and Allah. And this, targhib and tarhib. Tarhib and tarhib. So now, what it came here in this verse? Tarhib, warning, discouragement, slow down. It's serious, this tarhib, putting fear in you. Now comes with the tarhib and talk to the other, because this was addressing the kuffar. لِيُنْذِرَ بَأْسًا شَدِيدًا مِنْ لَدُنْ. But in the same time, وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. What is bashara? Is a verb that means to give a good news. Okay? Bashara, yubashiru, and al-bishara is the glad tiding itself. Giving somebody good news. He said to somebody, what? Abshir billadhi yasurruk. Have good news. Okay? Coming glad tiding to you. Something that will make you happy. Jump. Hit the ceiling, okay? And the bishara, takunu bil khair al muntazar fil mustaqbal. The bishara is good news that somebody telling you is coming to you in the future. Okay? And in this, we notice that had mentioned, you see, subhanAllah. The tafsir is a beautiful. He said, notice here, when he talk about the tabshir, the good tiding and the glad news, he mentioned the people. Okay? But in the other verse, he did not talk about the kuffar directly. Okay? He said, لِيُنْذِرَ بَأْسًا شَدِيدًا مِنْ لَدُونَ. He did not say to the kuffar. Okay?
Why?
Notice this. Why? Okay. Here, he didn't say, same way like the previous, is not verse, the previous word. Because this from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even in the way how he speak and the way how he talk. Okay? But when he came about the rahmah and the mercy, he mentions him. So even Allah, his warning, but in his warning also, making it easy. Okay? Instead, you're the one who did this. Okay? You get, okay? But we can say, okay, guys, whosoever took a nap in the class, see, go and make wudu. Instead of embarrassing. And this is the reason the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say in the khutbah, what? ما بال أقوام يفعلون كذا وكذا. Okay? What's wrong with some people? And can be maybe one person only in the community did this. But the Prophet will talk what? In general. So Allah said, لِيُنْذِرَ بَأْسًا شَدِيدًا مِنْ لَدُونَ. But he did not say to who? Of course it's not going to be for those who make salah. But you will get the hint. Okay? Why Allah will punish you unless you're doing something bad? Huh? So even in the asloob, even in the wording, the addressing, Allah is still making it easy. It maybe will soften their heart and bring them to Islam. But when it came about the glad tiding, he had mentioned the people. Okay? وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And the mu'mineen is the plural of mu'min. Okay? Mu'mineen. And after this he said, مَاكِثِينَ فِيهِ أَبَدًا. مَاكِثِينَ. Okay, sorry, excuse me. وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Now he's going to give qualification about them describing. All right, he said, الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. And this again to teach us that Islam is not only a mere belief, principles that you memorize it, six principles. أَمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَةِ وَكُتِبِ وَرَسُلِ أَمْ إِيمَان مُفَصَّلِ إِيمَان مُكَسَّلِ. No, it is reality that you live it. It is also akhlaq. It is a way dealing with others. The way how you interact. If there is Iman, this is a foundation. So you go, you spend all your money, put it in foundation. After this, no windows, no walls, no doors. So what did we do? Where are you going to live? When it's rain, you're going to get wet, you and your family. Is it? So we need Iman and Amal Salih. Okay? So Iman by itself is not enough. And good deed without Iman is not acceptable. So, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Always they found like twins in the Quran. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيُبَشِّرَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. Those who do righteousness. Righteousness. الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. And now here we want to stop a little bit over this word, الصالحات. الصالحات is a plural of صالحة. Okay. And صالح, which is good, or right, or upright. Right. When you say عمل صالح, to qualify the work or the deed to be صالح. Because عمل, acting, doing. But Allah is saying, عَمِلْ صَالِحْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. What will make a عمل, a deed, to be صالح or not صالح? Okay? وَقُلْ عَمَلُوا. But the عمل itself, action, somebody running, okay? The machine is running, but does the machine produce something or not? There is nothing coming out of the machine. But the machine is working. Something wrong. Huh? So it's not enough that you exert this energy, that you keep going and coming, keeping and going to the mosque, and you understand reading this. No. There is some to qualify a deed to be a salih, to be righteous, to be acceptable. Two qualifications. Two conditions. Number one, ikhlas. Number one, ikhlas, sincerity, to be devoted only to Allah, for the pleasure of Allah. You can spend, all right? You can spend the whole wealth. But what did he spend it? He spent it so your name going to be in the newspaper. He built a whole hospital. And after this, making a big picture and a statue and the name, or the mosque, masjid, sheikh so-and-so. Or mosque of Amir so-and-so. Okay? Why did he do it? Did he do it for the fame and the game and the name? Or he did it for Allah? We know the famous hadith of Abu Huraira, the one that we were looking for it last night, Abu Jamila, 1:30 in the morning. Okay? Yeah? This is the same one. Three people, the first three people going to go to hellfire. A Hafiz Quran, a charitable person, and a person who died in the battlefield. What you can imagine more than a person lose all his life and after this go to hellfire? Oh, you see, he said, Leish. And Allah will bring him in the day of judgment. Said, وَيُذَكِّرُوا بِنِعَمِ عَلَيْهِ فَيَذْكُرْهَا. Allah will remind you with his favor upon you. Say, yes, Allah, I remember all this. You was healthy, you were strong, your muscles that big, you have very strong heart, you don't scare from all these machine guns, you're running it. You love it. But why did you fight? Oh Allah, I qataltu fika hatta stushit. Oh Allah, I fought in the battlefield until I was murdered. Said kadhabt. Allah say, you are a liar. Walakin qatalta liyuqala jari. Liyuqala jari. You fought so people can say what? He's a brave man. So in his heart, this was in his heart. His intention, his aim was not Allah, was the people. Same thing, the hafiz, the teacher, the sheikh. The same thing, the charitable person. وَلَكِنَّكْتَ أَنْفَقْتَ لِيُقَالَ جَوَادِ. You spend so they can say, he's a charitable person, he's this, he's that. Oh, subhanallah, brother, this man. If the people talk about you, without you attending this, subhanallah, okay? This is something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recorded for you. Allah bless you with it. عَاجِلُ بُشْرَ الْمُؤْمِنِ. Okay? Allah give you glad tidings in this life before even the hereafter. But if you do it with intention, now you spoil your deed. If you spend so the people can do, if you teach for purpose people to talk about you, now you spoil it. You didn't do it for Allah. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and yirzuqna al-ikhlas. And this is not something simple, brothers and sisters. We have really, really to fight ourselves. Because the shaitan, this is his work, try to spoil your good deed. That we have to fight our own intention, our own self, that we doing it for Allah, not for anything else. Now the people going to praise me or not, they see me or not, doesn't matter. For Allah, and they say. And when you look in the history of Islam, you found widows, orphans been supported for 40, 50 years and nobody know who. And when they got to know, when the person who used to wait until it gets dark and he go and leave the food in front of the steps of the door and keep walking. So now when the man die, now this widow or this orphan no more food. Because the man who used to do it, they don't know who. Now, when he died, nobody doing it. Because nobody even from his family know about it. Nobody in the community know about it. Doing it for the sake of Allah. Gets dark, he go take this big bag of rice and put it in front of the door and keep walking. The woman comes and when he get out, he sees this. And continuing every night. After 40, 50, whatever years, the man died. No more supplies. Now they got to know that so-and-so who died is the person who used to do this. See how some of these early believers used to be so concerned about whenever they do a good deed that nobody else has anything in it. They do it only for Allah, for the pleasure of Allah. Doesn't matter. You do it for Allah, do it. Or the imam praise you, or the imam appreciate it, or the imam didn't like it. So what? So what? Who's the imam? Who's the shura? Who's the community? Who's the government? What is the news? What's the TV? TV is not going to go with you in the grave. It's going to be a good, handsome man coming to you in the grave while you're by yourself. فَقُلْ مَنْ أَنْتَ فَوَجْهُكَ الْوَجْهُ يَجِيءُ بِالْخَيْرِ. So who are you? Your face is have this pleasure and this smile. Who are you coming here? He said, "Ana amaluka as-salih alladhi kunta ta'malni fi ad-dunya." I am your good deed that you used to do it in the dunya. Now I'm coming here to keep you company. Doesn't matter. The imam acknowledge you, the community acknowledge you, the people put your name and put somebody else's name in the news and say the reporters. Who cares? Allah sees, Allah hears. Okay? So number one is the ikhlas, sincerity. Do it for the pleasure of Allah. If it's teaching, if it's preaching, if it's da'wah, if it's sadaqah, Whatever that you doing it, you doing it for Allah. If somebody come and say thank you, or jazakallah khairan, or appreciate what you did, he didn't invent it. So alhamdulillah, no problem. Okay? Number two, for the deed to be salih. وَبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ what? الصالحات. That number two to be what? According the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay? If your work, if your deed, salah, hajj, umrah, whatever, dhikr, your belief is not matching the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, forget it. Anybody heard the CD called Termites? Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry. Inshallah, we're going to get the book of termites, inshallah. All right? So the exterminator come to your house now? So, we have to be careful. Not only do, but we need to protect what we're doing. Shelter it. Don't spoil it. You're going to spoil it by showing off or but doing it, but is not matching the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As a result of this, Aisha radiallahu anha reported it. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man amila amalan. We're talking about amal now, okay? Laysa alayhi amruna fahuwa rad. Whosoever do any deed, any amal, this is what Allah said, wa yubashshira alladhina ya'malun. Any deed is not in accordance with my teaching, it will be rejected. And this is the reason, brothers, we in this masjid, alhamdulillah, keep emphasizing the sunnah, the way of the Prophet. What did the Sahaba do? What did the Sahaba understand? It is very important. Be on a sunnah. As they say, a little deed according sunnah, much better than a lot of deed, but not in a sunnah. Okay? You do a little, but according to the sunnah will be acceptable. But you do a lot, and it's not sunnah, none of it will be accepted, will be thrown. Okay? وَيُبَشِّرَ الَّذِينَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا حَسَنًا. That for them will be what? Only reward? A good reward. Okay? A goodly reward. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those believers who do a righteous deed sincerely for the pleasure of Allah according to the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah makes the ajr hasanan. Is for us and all the Muslims, inshallah, ameen. And inshallah, we're about to close. And before we finish, we take our homework for today, that we repeat this verse, inshallah, for few times. So inshallah, when you memorize it, right, inshallah. First, I think we already had translate the verse. So, right, before we finish, anybody have anything about the verse today? Only the verse of today. We are not going to talk about halal meat or multi wives or anything. Okay, only second verse. Okay. Anybody? Any question? Any term? Anything is not clear? Grammar. Verb, noun. All right. Alhamdulillah. Qayyiman. Say, Qayyiman. I know some of you more advanced in the study, but we have some new Muslims also in the website. So we're going to have to be word to word and two words, inshallah, to help them. All right, brothers and sisters, inshallah, we're going to say it in Arabic now. And if you don't have your Quran, please get your Quran, surah number 18, verse number 2. Qayyiman.
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 قيماً لينذر بأساً شديداً من لدن ويبشر
المؤمنين
الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا
قيما لينذر
بأسا شديدا
شديدا من لدن
ويبشر المؤمنين الذين
يعملون الصالحات
أن لهم أجرا حسنا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدن لينذر stick your tongue a little bit
قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدن
ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات
أن لهم أجرا حسنا
الله سبحانه وتعالى knows best. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. And for those who are on Chat Islam, I'm your host Muhammad Saad Adli from Columbia, South Carolina. Until I see you tomorrow, inshallah, 4 p.m. Eastern Time, our usual class, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khairan for being here tonight. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك and Allah knows best.